Meanwhile, a restaurant that sits in the shadow of Gillette Stadium has suddenly closed just days before the big game.
Eyewitness News reporter Steve Nielsen's been looking into it, and he joins us now live in studio with what he's learned. New at 6. Steve?
Well, Mike Shannon, the why here is a little confusing. In the last 30 minutes, I received a statement from Toby Keith's I Love This Bar. A representative said Patriot Place stole their business and disregarded 100 employees' livelihoods by gouging them with rent. They added that Patriot Place will be taking the contents of the business tomorrow. Patriot Place, though, said this was mutual. Regardless, the timing has some customers scratching their heads.
I caught up with James Bertram steps from the entrance to Gillette Stadium.
It's a lot of people are crowding. I want to get in there and watch the game.
He was a former dishwasher at Toby Keith's I Love This Bar and Grill, a restaurant in Patriot Place. The popular spot was silent Wednesday morning, though. A sign out front thanked customers and announced that they are now closed.
It's really surprised, you know, because that's like the one of the popular spots out there, you know. It was like, I used to work there, and it used to be jam-packed, even on Pats games, you know what I mean? The line would be out the door, even though everyone was seeing, you know, everyone would be, I can't believe it's closed, you know?
Especially on game day, another sign out front advertises Patriots watch parties at the bar, but it'll be empty for the big game Sunday. A band set to play here in just a few weeks said no one's told them the gig's been canceled yet. A spokesperson for Patriot Place says they and the bar agreed to mutually end the lease.
The representative for Toby Keith's I Love This Bar and Grill also added again that tomorrow she expects Patriot Place to take the contents of the business tomorrow. I also asked what customers can do with gift cards. I didn't get a response to that. Patriot Place didn't respond to accusations other than say that it was mutual and that they wish the company well on future endeavors. I'm Steve Nielsen, Eyewitness News.